Over the course of this series of Muqaddimah, we've journeyed through Ibn Khaldun's thoughts on politics, economics, and social structures. In our last episode, we delved into the pivotal roles of educational and religious institutions in shaping civilizations. Today, we turn to a topic at the heart of Ibn Khaldun's legacy. His unique perspective on the classification of sciences, his philosophical approach to knowledge, and his critiques of educational methods. This exploration will not only uncover Ibn Khaldun's views on the nature and purpose of science, but also his thoughts on how knowledge should be pursued and taught. Join us as we explore the depths of Ibn Khaldun's analysis, which challenges us to rethink not only how we learn, but also how we apply the principles of scientific inquiry in our daily lives and academic pursuits. Ibn Khaldun meticulously categorizes the sciences into two broad types: 1. Philosophical sciences, and 2. Traditional, conventional sciences. He defines the philosophical sciences as those which man can discern through reason and empirical observation. He states,
"The first kind comprises the philosophical sciences, with which man can become acquainted through the very nature of his ability to think. These include logic, medicine, mathematics, and physics, which allow individuals to engage with the world through analysis and deduction."
Contrastingly, Ibn Khaldun discusses the traditional conventional sciences, which he describes as based largely on the authoritative teachings of religious law. He explains,
"The second kind comprises the traditional conventional sciences. All of them depend upon information based on the authority of the given religious law."
This category includes sciences such as Quran interpretation and jurisprudence, essential for maintaining the moral and legal framework of society. Ibn Khaldun believed in the importance of a well-rounded education, advocating for the study of both philosophical and traditional sciences to achieve a comprehensive understanding of the world. He argues that this dual approach enriches one's perspective, combining empirical knowledge with spiritual and ethical guidance. Ibn Khaldun championed a critical approach to science that valued empirical observation and reasoned analysis over blind acceptance of authority. He emphasized,
"It should be known that blind trust in the data of earlier authorities is a mark of people's ignorance about the nature of the intellect and its secrets."
Further elaborating on his philosophy, Ibn Khaldun argued against the uncritical acceptance of past knowledge, stating,
"The reliance on the works of a scholar without understanding their reality is a mark of the decline of sciences. The true scholar is he who constantly questions, revises, and updates his knowledge through evidence."
Ibn Khaldun was critical of educational methods that did not foster an active and questioning intellect. He cautioned against the dangers of accepting information without questioning its basis in reality, asserting that
"The worst mistake is to consider as definitive the information obtained from teachers and to rely on it entirely in other matters."
By advocating for a science grounded in empirical evidence and critical reasoning, Ibn Khaldun laid the groundwork for modern scientific inquiry, emphasizing that knowledge should always be tested and never accepted without proof. Ibn Khaldun was critical of the educational methods of his time, particularly the reliance on rote learning and the use of shortened texts that he believed stifled deep understanding. He stated,
"Many recent scholars have turned to brief presentations. This procedure is detrimental to good style and makes difficulties for the understanding."
He elaborated on the negative impact of these methods, explaining,
"The texts of such brief handbooks are found to be difficult and complicated. It confuses the beginner by presenting the final results of a discipline to him before he is prepared for them."
This method, according to Ibn Khaldun, prevents students from developing a true understanding and appreciation of the subject matter. To counter these ineffective methods, Ibn Khaldun recommended more interactive teaching approaches that promote independent thinking and gradual learning. He advised,
"The teaching of scientific subjects to students is effective only when it proceeds gradually and little by little."
He emphasized the importance of adapting teaching methods to the student's intellectual readiness and natural progression in learning. Ibn Khaldun's insights into education advocate for a transformative shift towards methodologies that prioritize depth over breadth, understanding over memorization, and critical inquiry over passive reception. His call for educational reform reflects a timeless understanding of how best to cultivate knowledgeable, thoughtful, and innovative minds. Ibn Khaldun's theories on education and science continue to resonate within modern discussions about pedagogy and the philosophy of science. His emphasis on critical thinking and empirical observation serves as a cornerstone for contemporary educational models that advocate for inquiry-based learning and scientific skepticism. Today, educators and scholars recognize the value of Ibn Khaldun's approach to learning, which aligns closely with modern pedagogical strategies that prioritize student interaction and practical application of knowledge. His call for rigorous evidence and questioning of established norms encourages a more thoughtful and analytical approach to scientific studies and education. Throughout this series, we've explored Ibn Khaldun's profound insights across sociology, economics, history, and science, uncovering the depth and breadth of his influence. His holistic approach to analyzing human civilizations provides a timeless framework for understanding the complex interplay between various aspects of society. As we conclude our journey through the Muqaddimah, we reflect on Ibn Khaldun's enduring legacy and the relevance of his theories in helping us navigate both historical and contemporary phenomena. His work not only bridges the past with the present, but also offers a roadmap for future scholarly exploration. Thank you for joining us on this enlightening exploration. We invite you to share your thoughts on how Ibn Khaldun's ideas resonate with your experiences and insights. Continue the conversation in the comments below, and keep exploring the rich legacy of Ibn Khaldun. Until next time, keep questioning, keep learning.